Preparation. Preparation is your foundation. It is the behavior that places you steps ahead of potential enemies. You should never enter a situation unprepared. It is your duty to always have prior insight on the potential dangers and mishaps of all that you subject yourself and others to. Every step that you take outside of your front door begins with an assessment and prediction of what could go wrong between now and when you return. Habitually hope for the best while expecting the worst. All right, that's really important. You see what I said here. When you, every step that you take outside of your front door, now first of all, you should have your home safe, locked down, secure. You can't be a protector if you don't know how to protect yourself. I don't care what neighborhood you live in. You know, there's so many people, oh, I live in this great neighborhood. Nobody, we leave our doors unlocked and our garages open. All it takes is one escaped criminal. You know, and he's coming at, now you got a home invasion. You know what kind of things happen there? And then you're a security agent. I mean, your house should be locked down. You should be, that should be, so that's, make sure your homes are secure. Or you can't protect others because you can't even teach somebody about protecting themselves because you're sacrificing security for comfort. You never sacrifice security for comfort or fun. Okay, so when you step out your door, you have to imagine everything that can go wrong. If I'm going to protect my client, or I'm going and I'm expected to be there, this person has counted on me to protect them or protect the establishment, whatever it is that I'm doing, I have to make it there. So I have to make sure I have gas in my car. I have to make sure I'm not going to get a flat tire, and if I do, I have a spare tire. I have to make sure I'm going to make it there on time. I have to make sure when I'm driving that I don't let this idiot hit me because he's not paying attention to what he's doing. I have to make sure when I'm in rush hour traffic that when I'm not following him too closely because when he slams his brake because he's following him too closely, I slam my. Now this clown just rear-ended me and drove up the back of my neck and snapped my neck in half. Now I can't make it to my job to protect someone. So from the minute I step out of that door, I am on point to make sure I can keep to my word.